is up, the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Slipgator here, hanging out today, doing stuff and things on the Mod South server. I hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a really good day. I felt a little chilly, you know, so I was just kind of taking a break down here in the lava ocean, just kind of getting warmed up. Ooh, I feel like there's lag. I feel like there's a lot of lag. I don't know what's going on there. So actually what I was doing is going ahead and get a tier 5 blaze spawner going. So I was in the nether looking for that. So I got the tier 5 soul shard. We got the tier 5 enderman spawner. I just grabbed a ghast one, and we have the creeper one that's at tier 4. We're going to be looking to get that guy to tier 5. Today what we're going to be doing... Let's go ahead and get this on our bar real quick. Take this guy out. What we're going to be doing is working on getting some spawning online. So there's a lot of different things that I'm trying to do, different things I'm trying to build, and it's just not working out for me because I'm going the wrong way. Because I keep running into, when I'm trying to do projects and stuff off camera, I keep running into issues where I just don't have enough stuff and things. Like, I don't have enough ender pearls, I don't have enough of this, I don't have enough of that. Let me see, where are we going to be going here? X is another portal. That looks good. So I just don't have enough stuff and things. So, also, Blood Magic is amazing. And so is the Bound Armor. So, so we're going to get some spawners going today. We're going to get something automated so that we have a certain amount, you know what I mean, of stuff and things in our system at all times so that we don't have to worry about that anymore. And when I go to do a project, I can just do my project and not have to worry about, I'm out of Ender Pearls, or, oh, I'm out of this, or, oh, I'm out of that. It's a big pain in the butt, man. We don't like that. So how do I get in here? Oh, yeah, right here. So that's what we're going to be doing today. So we're going to be heading back to the Tech HQ. And as far as building the blood magic stuff and things, we're going to get to that in, I think, the next episode. I keep saying that, and I feel really bad about saying that all the time, and I feel bad that we're not doing the building. But time is becoming an issue. With the wedding coming up, there's a lot of things that are going on IRL. And it's just becoming an issue that I'm running low on time. So we're going to do this, and it's going to be cool, and I'm excited about it. And it is something that we need to get done, so that's good. For ideas for the Blood Magic Tower, I do have some cool ideas. I did a little bit of brainstorming. I did my patented thing that I do to help me know, or to help me understand what I'm building. Do I not have a chunk loader over here? Are you for reals? I seriously don't, do I? Oh, man. I think I've got one right in here, though, don't I? Right there. Oh, man. I'm glad that I figured that out. I'm glad I thought of that. So let's go ahead and squirt it right into here for nowsies, and then up that to 5x5. Perfect. So one of the things that we got to be cautious about when we're doing this, creating these spawners, and we've already got the tier 5 right here for Enderman, for Withers, and this is going to give us bones and Wither skulls. So one of the things we got to be careful about is that I don't want to create this in this area, really, to be honest with you. I don't want it to be here. I want it to be somewhere where it's going to run and not cause a whole lot of lag for us. I don't know. I guess it won't run really that often. We could maybe put it here. It might be cool, but I feel like hiding it would be better. Because of the lag issues, these sort of spawners can cause, you know, a good amount of lag. And so normally they're better to just be hidden. My ideas were to either putting it in the mining dimension. We've already got a few chunk-loaded chunks there, and it doesn't really matter if that dimension's a little extra laggy. No one really, you know what I mean? People got quarries there, but they're not, like, playing there. Or we could do it here behind the Tech HQ somewhere. But again, I'm worried about the lag issue. There probably won't be any. You know what? I know it would just be cooler if it's here, man. Don't you think? Yeah, I hear you. You do. Well, I know, but the lag, I know, but, you know, it won't be that laggy. It will be at first when it initially runs, but then after that, once we've got, like, a stockpile of stuff and things in the system, it will be cool. So we're going to do it here. So I think behind the Tech HQ is going to be a good spot. And this is going to be fairly simple in that we're just going to use a really, really big drop. So I think that we're just going to do it right here. And all we're going to do is use a really, really large drop to do this. Yeah, that's how we're going to get our items. And I'm pretty sure it should work okay that way. I don't know if Withers drop skulls when dropped. That's a good question. Let's find out. So that'll be a good test right now. Let's go ahead and do that. So let's go ahead and build a tower up here. Oh, come on, super fast thing. Here we go, like this. And we'll build it high enough that we don't have to worry about anything surviving, like, say, that high. And then we'll go ahead and take... Where'd that soul cage go? We got the shard out of it, right? There's the wither skeleton shard. I didn't realize that was only a tier 3. But the cage broke. I thought those stuck around. That's no problem. We could build another one. I actually may even have some in here already. Nope. So where's that empty soul cage like that? Let's go ahead and build a bunch. And we'll grab one real fast. Head over here. And let's just test this out. Because if they don't drop... Could we go up? If they don't drop wither skulls from drop damage, then that's no bueno. We don't want that at all. So, all right. We'll go there. Wither skeleton shard. Squirt. Lever. Squirt. Bam. And then we'll tear this down real quick. Let's take a look here. Also, did you notice how quickly I'm mining that? Is that not the most amazing thing that ever happened? Now that I have the haste 2 on in conjunction with, I can't remember if the Sojourner Sash gives me increased speed or not, but just, what? Oh, that's going to be an issue. So we will have to put spikes down at the very least because those things are spawning. Oh, there's the cage right there, man. All right, so this is going to be one of our tests. We're going to take a look and see if that drops them. And then just to also make sure that none of those little guys are surviving, we're going to go ahead and put some of these guys here. But yeah, I'm going to run this test for a few minutes, see how stuff and things works, and then I'll BRBs.
Mod South.
So I have this little area over here, and I landscaped out my stuff and things a little bit, covered up a couple of holes, you know, just making it more beautifuler everywhere. And I think what we're going to do here is an 11 by 11. So I got that all mapped out, I do believe. And then also, I think I was telling you guys before, man, you got to be so careful with the atomic disassembler now. It is crazy fast with all the stack stuff I got on it now with haste and the Sojourner Sash. And everything, or I think it's just the haste that's doing it. I mean, check this out. Like, I think it's faster than Instabreak. Like, it's like the best thing that ever happened, man. That's so crazy. But we want to go ahead, and when we're doing this, we're going to use the same sort of architecture that we used in the tech HQ, so it kind of matches up. Perfect. So, yeah. So we're going to put some wedge slopes around the outside edge here. And then we're going to probably end up having to have a couple of different areas because I want to do blaze here. I'm going to need grinders to do that. We're going to grind up the wither skeletons as well. Am I out of wedges? I need more wedgies, man. So we're going to have to grind up the... What? Carpenters, wedge slope. Wait, where are you? Here you are. Recipe. Bam. Stack. Sweet. And I did went ahead and threw an anchor over here, so it'll be a lot faster for me to move around. So like that. And then what did I cover those with? Smooth ones. So that way it'll look the same. So yeah, we're going to do that there. Like I was saying. Oh, see you later. So we're going to, do blaze wither skeletons on, I think, like the bottom floor here. And then that will have grinders on it. We'll integrate that to pick up the mob essence. And I was thinking about that mob essence stuff. That means we're also going to have to get... I've been kind of resistant to do this because a lot of the other guys had done a lot of series on it. I know DMAC did it. I know Z did it. But we are going to need to get bedrockium going, bedrockium ingots. Because we're going to need to get a bedrockium drum. Now, if you guys aren't familiar, if you haven't happened to see those guys' series on it, the bedrockium drums allow you to store, I mean, it's like, I don't even know, some ridiculous amount of liquid in a single drum. So it's way more efficient that way. So we want to do that. We want to use that. We want to use those bedrockium storage drums. So we'll have to figure that out. I don't think we'll get it going today. And I might even go ahead and just do it off camera and show you guys. No, I'm a little bit of a mistake. No big deal. Atomic disassembler at haste 2. So, all right, something like this. Now, we got to go ahead and get those grinders going. I think what I'm going to do is grab a chest over here, too. So let me go ahead and just grab a diamond chest right here. And then do I have any of those grinders made up? I don't. So we should be able to go ahead and make some. And I do believe 4 will be enough. So, oh, we're out of stuff and things. What do we need? Pistons and gold swords. So let me see here. Oh, weird. Huh. That I don't know what just happened there. The terminal was showing me Oh, because I didn't shift click it, it just shows you the recipe. I didn't know it did that. Rad. All right. So let's just go ahead and get some pistons online. We'll just make a stack of those. And then the gold swords, too, we'll just make like 17 or 4 or whatever that was. Perfect. So now we should be able to make what? Out of books? For real, Zors? I'm probably going to run out of leather, too. Oh, my gosh, man. What is this? This is crazy. No paper? Book, paper, shift click, bam. All right. So do we get enough books to make the last one here? Or wait, we need 2, 3, bam. All right, so we're good to go. All right, finally. Oh, my God, man. Oh, yeah, we're going to need some energy conduit, and we're going to need tesseracts. That's something else I got to get online as well. We'll probably need a couple of these guys. Let's just grab them right here. All right, so if we pop back over, right in this area, now, with it being this size, I think that I'm going to have to put my grinders all the way on the outside here and then probably do something like that where we're making it look more beautiful or this way. Yeah, we'll do it like this. So, yeah, grinders on the around the outside edge, and then we'll use wireless redstone to control it, of course. We'll put some level emitters inside the ME system. That's what we're going to use to go ahead and have it tell the system when to turn these on and off. So, I think I'm going to go ahead and get that all wired up. I'm going to figure out where inside the Tech HQ we want to put the level emitters and get the wireless redstone going too. Do I have any of those guys? I don't. All right, so I got a couple things to make. I'm going to work on it, get something set up for you guys, and I'll BRBs. Fly. So it's an amazing transition. Thank you.
Mod South.
All right, so here's what we've got so far, guys. We got a tesseract right here squirting power out to the four grinders, and we're going to go ahead and cover up the floor right here. And then we got our four grinders, and those each have a tesseract on top, and those tesseracts are all wired to send juice, mob juice. Now, we haven't got that bedrockium drum like I talked about, but we're going to get there. We'll get that eventually, but for now, we definitely want to get a little bit of this mob juice. So yeah, these are all set to send only fluid under spawner liquid. And then we got a couple of their cages right here on a couple of different frequencies. So 18-19, because over at the Botania, when we set up the TNT, we set it up for 18-18. This is 18-19, 18-20. Just put some blocks in between to stop spawns, stop spawning on top of there. I don't know if they'll spawn one block up. I don't think so, but we'll see. And it's no big deal if there's one on top of there, but we might as well try to curb that as much as we can. So for now, we've got a tesseract, and I'm not sure if the transfer node can go directly onto a tesseract. We'll have to figure that out. But then we got a couple of drums here just to get a little extra squirt juice. And oh man, I didn't get these fixed up yet. Let me go ahead and finish these up here. And you see, we got the tower looking pretty much like we had the Tech HQ, so it's going to match. And we'll put a top on it because what we're going to end up doing is making this really, really tall. And the upper part is going to be a fall trap for Endermen and Creepers. I think that's going to be it. All right, so we squirt inside of here. We got this. Now, this is a little bit of an explanation as to why these look the way they do. If you put these wireless transmitters directly onto the level emitter, it doesn't work. They won't work. So it's really kind of screwy. It's really weird to play with it. If you do, say you have it next to the level emitter and you put up and you block update the transmitter, it will update, but you have to block update the transmitter. So you have to place something. Like if you were to place a block like that, bam, it would update. So because it wouldn't work directly next to the level emitter, and I tried above and below and on the side, I went ahead and set this up in this fashion. So we just use some red alloy wire right here, and then that will work. And you can see it right here. If I look at the level emitter and I set this for like 300, you can see it turns on. It's working perfect. So we're going to set this, the wither skeletons and the blaze. And we're going to set these guys up. I want 10,000 blaze rods, and I want 500 wither skulls. So let's go ahead and see if this all works now. We got it all set up. So both of these guys should be on now. All right, sweet. And then that means we got to put them in. Oh, crap. I forgot exactly what frequencies were what. So this guy is 18-19. All right, 18-19 is withers. Just remember that. Write it down for me for a sec here. 18-19 is withers. So we got, let's get our spawner thingy-doodle. Oh, wait, they're in here. So let's grab these guys. Blaze on top, withers on the bottom. And I got to get that. I got to upgrade this shard for sure. So let's go ahead and squirt these into here and these into here. And it should take a second, and they should turn on. Yeah? Yeah, you guys going to turn on? Or is it because it's daytime? They don't like that? I can never remember. The Blaze one is tier 5, man. It should just work. Maybe I got to toggle that redstone. Let's go ahead and take a look at that. Yeah, stuff and things doesn't ever seem to work just exactly the way you want it. So let's toggle these both off. Give them a second to, like, breathe or whatever. Oh, we got to go lower. And then let's set it. Let's just set it for 2,000. Let's just do the blaze and see what happens. There we go. So there, our blaze are turning on. Sweet. Are we getting blaze rods? Bam, they're going in there. Are we getting squirt juice? Bam, everything's working, man. It all worked out perfectly. So I tell you what, normally 9 times out of 10, because I do so much stuff on cam and I don't really test, I like the creative process with you guys. Stuff and things doesn't necessarily always work as I planned. But this time, everything's looking like it's going pretty good. Sweet. So let's go ahead and head back up. And let's squirt this guy on. Oh, 1,200 is a little high. Let's go with 500 just to have. And then that's going to give us huge amounts of everything else. So the necrotic, and let me show you this real quick. So the bones, I've already got 1,000 necrotic bones, and I've got 23,000 regular bones. So it's going to give us a huge amount of bones. If we need bones or something like that, we can always just turn it up or set a different level emitter on the same frequency for bones. And then it will go ahead and turn that on. So we got that guy. You know what? I know that this spawner's not working. Oh, these guys, they keyed in on me. Crap. Oh, man. No, just relax, everybody. Just relax. So I know that spawner, the problem with it, because it's only a tier 3, it's not going to work while the sun is out. So that ain't going to work for us, or we'll have to cover it up. So, and it looks pretty good. I think it's cool. I want to add something down inside of here. So let me actually squirt into this guy. Let's go ahead and turn these off real quick. Will that turn that guy off? And it doesn't matter with that one. So we'll turn these guys off. Oh my God. Oh no. Where are you guys going, man? Oh, is that redstone powering that other one? Bad move. Whoops. All right, so that should shut off now. Come on, guys. Come on down here, man. You're going to like it down here. Yeah, just come on right down here. No, it's cool. Everything's good. Just come down to this area. And you know what I'll do? This is actually pretty cool. Let's go ahead and pull this bobble off and put this guy on, and we won't get knockbacked anymore. Come on. Grind them up, grinders. So, all right, so what I want to do, maybe I'll just take him out because it's taking too long. All right, there we go. So I just want to add a little bit of edging inside of here to make this look a little better. Where? Come on, man. So I want to add this little edging to make this look a little bit better. And I'm not sure if I got enough blocks, but it'll look nicer. Actually, you know what will be even better than that? Just to make it a little more beautifuler. Let's go like this. One of these, one of those, one of them, and then we'll take out the center ring just to add a little bit of contrast to this area so it looks a little bit cooler. And we'll do this. Now, I probably really should go spend some time in the Nether and get that spawner up to tier 5. I could also make an MFR spawner and then just grind them out that way. It's probably faster, honestly. It'll probably be what I do. So we can make that into a tier 5. But the next stage of this is getting the creepers and the Enderman online. And that's really the biggest thing. The biggest reason that I wanted to take this on is because of the Enderman thing. I really need Ender Pearls and a lot of them. They're just used in so many recipes now. It actually is almost silly, in my humble opinion, how many recipes those are used in. See, just adding that little piece really makes it look a lot better. But it's kind of silly, I think, almost how many recipes Ender Pearls are used in. So we got to get that online too. And the quick drop for Enderman, or the drop distance, is really high. It's like, I don't even know, 70 or something like that? I can't remember exactly what it is. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cover this guy up. That way we're not going to get any more spawns in here. Then I'm going to go ahead and start building the top piece so that we can go ahead and get the drop built. And I'll BRBs!
Mod South.
And we're back. I got to turn these guys off. We're a little bit laggy here. So we'll just switch these like so. And we should be good to go. Look at that. So I got 2 more transmitters set up on 1821 and 1822. And this guy over here is set up for 5,000 enderpearls. This guy is set up for 5,000 gunpowder, of which we already have enough. So we'll turn it on just to test it here in a sec. Or we could just turn it on right now. Well, we'll turn it on here in a sec. 1821 is our Ender Pearls. So let's head back over here. Man, this thing's still... They're still going. See, something's up with these, man. I don't know what's up with that. It should be turned off. And that should... They should both be turned off. They're not getting redstone signal. I don't know what's going on there, man. All right, let's go ahead and turn these off, because that is really odd. I don't know why it's doing that. Let's just grab some levers, and we may just have to replace them. But you can see I'm getting some frame rate dropage from that. So let's go ahead and head in here. And this actually shouldn't work, to be honest with you. I shouldn't be able to turn them off with a lever. They should turn on with a lever. Maybe if I just update them. If I can get out of here, I can get out. I swear I can. All right, I'm out. And did we get them to turn off? All right, looks like they're both off now. So that's really odd. I wonder what's going on with that. Maybe I'll have to play around that a little bit more. I don't know if it was just because it was the initial time that I set it up or something like that, or if those wireless transceivers really do have a problem with block updates. If I come down here, these guys will get killed by the grinders. But that really kind of stinks. Those aren't working quite as easily as they should be. So let's go ahead and head up, and we'll set these up at the very least anyway. We got to get these going. All right, so we got the this guy. We got the this guy. It was 1820. Crap! This is the Enderman spawner. 1821. All right, so 1821's our Enderman spawner. And then let's just do this. It'll be easier to get up top. Whoa! Oh, man. Blood magic OP. All right. So we'll put the Enderman spawner right here. Like so. 21. And then this will be 1822. Like so. Bam! All right, so that's on. So we'll put the creeper shard in here. And we'll put the Enderman shard in here. Wait. Huh? Wait. Huh? Crap! Huh? What? Go in there. All right, I thought I had to shift it in. So, all right, this should go ahead and turn on now. I'm hoping. Let's grab a lever. And I want to put some levers on these just so that they're easier to disable if you ever need to. That way we won't have to, like, go grab levers again the next time we have a problem with one. All right, wow, one squirt of the squirt makes me go all the way up as far as you can go. So, yeah, this thing is not working the way that it should. There it goes. If we update it, it does work, and I'm not sure if it'll work forever and ever now. But I do believe we should see these guys automatically falling. Everything's working good. If we come down here, we're going to get some Ender Pearls in our inventory. But what I've got set up right here, holy crap, really loud. I've got to say hi to XBs. So we got our Ender Chest right here with the Advanced Item Collector is set for 10x5x10 radius. And that is making stuff and things happen. If we head back over into the Tech HQ and we take a look here, squirt some of the stuff that we got back into the inventory and we look at Ender Pearls, should see this it's going up pretty quickly. 95, 100, that's working great. Now, one of the things, the reason why the outside of this isn't complete, the blue clear glass you might have saw isn't there. So I need more clear glass, and so currently had to kind of up production. And so what I did, this is actually, and I don't know if you guys know this, this is another thing you got to look out for that I harp on this, or I say this quite a bit. This causes mad lag. I don't know why. But so I had a couple of lava drums, so I went ahead and hooked them up to my, what is it? Smeltery. Oh my gosh. And that way we got a lot of lava down inside of here. And I got a huge amount of sand in here. And I took a liquid transfer node. And then I piped that into multiple casting basins. And I've done this before in Monster and had the same problem. Whenever I piped it in, used a pipe or to multiple casting basins like this, you can see like mad frame issues. So it's not something that you can keep running all the time. But it's helping to make, oh my gosh, let me get out of here. It's helping to make a large amount of clear glass very quickly, which is something that we want in this. I'm trying to get this done. I wanted to get it done before I came back to talk to you, but it's just, even the setup I have over there just isn't making it fast enough. So if we head up here, you can see why we do want to go ahead and make sure this is completely covered. But it is going to take a minute for me to get all the stuff and things done to get the rest of this covered up. But the good thing is, at this point, this thing's pretty much operational. Well, we got to double check the update thing. I'm going to take a wild guess and say that we may need to wire this in a different way using a piece of alloy wire, similarly to what we did inside of here. It may just not be good at sending and receiving, as good at sending and receiving redstone signal for things that are adjacent as we had thought, as I previously thought. Oh, it looks like some of these guys are surviving. I'm not quite sure why or how that would be a thing. Are they not taking as much enough fall damage? Hold on, let's check this out. What is happening? Every once in a while, they're surviving. That's really weird, man. Every once in a while, they're surviving. Let's just turn that way down. I have no idea. Man, there's a little bit of fail going on today, but I'm happy with the level. I think I'm content with the level of fail. It's not that bad. We'll probably end up having to move that guy up or move this whole structure up a few blocks, but I feel like it's a good enough drop. I think it's 55 blocks, so it may just be that it's a little too low. Like if we switch those guys up, it probably would be fine. Because I think that what's happening is once in a while, the guys spawn a little bit low, and those are the ones that are surviving. So let me go ahead and really quickly just turn that off. And then we might have to make that change. Let's go in here. Click it, man. We'll just squirt that off. We have to go ahead and play cleanup with these Endermen. But yeah, so I'm going to take a couple more minutes. We're going to go ahead and get the rest of the clear glass done. We're going to move those spawners around, maybe lengthen this thing where a few more blocks just to guarantee that they're dying. Because with the amount of Endermen that we're going to have spawning here, we can't have this. We can't have all these guys surviving. It's just no, we just can't do it. So, and they're taking all my blocks, man. Holy crap. So I'm going to kill these guys off, make those changes, and I'll BRBs.
Mod South.
And we're back, and stuff and things are pretty much working exactly how I want them to. So all this stuff down here is working. These guys are going good. I think that I might add a couple more grinders. I think I might add two more per side over here, because these four don't seem to be keeping up quite as well as I'd like, but it is working down there. Now, the Enderman Fall, I raised it up by, basically it was below the spawner by two blocks, below this spawner by two blocks. I raised it up above it by two blocks, totally fixed it, no problem. No Endermen are surviving the fall, so that's good to go. The only issue that I'm having now that I cannot figure out for the life of me is that creeper spawner will not turn on, no matter what I do. The only thing I can guess is that it might have to do with magnum torches. But no matter what I do, this guy will not turn on. It's night right. I mean, it's tier 4, but it's night right now. The damn GD sounds. So it's night right now. They should turn on. It's totally should be fine. Cannot figure it out. I got empty soul cage. What's it say on it? Energy. Okay. Empty soul cage squirted in there. Tier 4 soul shard for creepers squirted in there. Get a lever on there. Bam, bam. Nothing happens. So I'm thinking that it might have to do with magnum torches because I don't know. I would assume magnum torches would stop. Well, magnum torches may not stop nether mobs from spawning, and I can't remember if they do. So it may not affect the wither skellies or the blazes or the endermen. Well, no, endermen are vanilla mob they spawn here. But maybe it's considered that they're from the end or something. I don't know. But I can't figure out how to turn it on. I can't figure out what's going on with it. So it might be magnum torches, which would suck because I want my magnum torches in the area. But at the very least, we got it up and running minus the creepers. But I think it looks really rad too. You know, the last thing I think that we probably should do is get it lit up a little bit better. Even though we got night vision, we still want to be able to make it appealing for the peeps that don't have night vision. Whoa! So let's grab and go ahead and squirt some lights on the top here. It's perfect placement. Near perfect. So we'll get these guys onto here like this. And we'll squirt one in the schmiddle. It's amazing. So beautiful. We'll put a couple more just because we're rich. Like that, like that, like that. Perfect. And then around the outside edges, we could probably add some lighting here too. Like, yeah. Oh, man, oh, man. Yeah. Like this, like that. Just to make it pretty. You know, I'm really thinking about taken night vision off. It caused me to have some different confusion when I was playing in the where the crap did my lights all go? Did you guys just see that happen? Is that a thing that just happened for real? Did I just run out and not notice it? So it's caused me to have some problems when I was in the cemetery, just kind of not understanding that I could light it up. And we need powered light. Powered light inverted. So let's build powered lights. How many of those can I do? 23. And then let's do power light inverted. Squirt. Bam. Then we got a couple more. But yeah, so it caused me to have some problems. And I also just think that the game looks better when you have that. Like, it's funny. Like, I'll probably end up turning it off and hating it. Are these not lighting up? What the crap? Powered light inverted. GD. So, GD at all the H. So I got to build a different kind of light. But Sixcraft doesn't. I'll fix it up after, man. So yeah, it's a thing, and it definitely was needed, like I was saying. I mean, now we don't have to worry about those items anymore. And I feel like a lot of times we're progressing through the trees of Batania so quick. We've gotten through, you know, the tier 5 of Blood Magic so fast that... and then in the middle, you know, we do some technology episodes. But because we're doing this stuff, we're kind of missing out on some of the tech. And I feel like it's good that we go back to do that every couple of episodes at the very least. So yeah, I think that's going to be it for today, guys. If you guys liked the video, please don't forget to hit the like button. Feel free to share and favorite it as you see fit, peeps. Don't spam it on Reddit. I hope you guys have a great rest of your day.